Hello there, Wanda Fay here, and it is Friday, March, Friday, March 8th, 2024, and it is 11:55 a.m. Pacific Time, 12:55 p.m. Mountain Time, 1:56 p.m. Central Time, 2:56 p.m. Eastern Time, I think, and I hope you all are having a great day. I'm having a great day. And of course, we had the Biden, President Biden, fake President Biden, State of the Union speech last night, which I was not going to watch it. I was not even going to watch it. And then I'm thinking, okay, well, it's kind of probably my duty to watch and keep up with things, of course, and because I'm really kind of all about news. But lately, you know, I've been so overwhelmed with such bad news. And praying, of course, blah, 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 that I'm just going, okay, you know, how much bad news can the soul really handle? So anyway, I'm just talking here. But I woke up this morning and I'm going, okay, what's a person to do when there's nothing else, when there's nothing else to do? Like, what is our hope? Well, our hope is in Jesus Christ, of course. Easier said than done, you know what I'm saying. So the Lord gave me Galatians 3:3, and it comes down to faith. And faith, and then I'm going to go over to 1 Corinthians 2, if you want to follow me. I'm on King James Version, public domain. So without putting people on a trip, because a lot of people are putting people on a trip these days, and I really get tired of it, okay? So now I probably do the same thing, of course, but, okay, we're all messed up, okay? We are all messed up, okay? And some more than others. I'm just saying, okay. But you know what? God loves us and God wants the best for us. God wants us to have everything. God wants us to be healthy and healed. You know, when you know these things, you know, you learn how to take no for an answer. Okay, you learn how to take no for an answer, no to the devil's schemes, no to the devil's evil, no to the devil's sickness and disease, no to the devil's lack. Now, before I get off onto a tangent, so in Galatians 3, so good, the book of Galatians is so good. And I'm still going over here. Okay, good. I hope I'm recording. 'Cause something came up on my screen and I'm going, whoa, am I still, so anyway, I'm sorry, I'm a little bit out of it today. But that's okay. So the book of Galatians is so great. All of the Bible is so great, of course, but the New Testament, the Gospels, of course, and the book of Galatians. I don't know what I'm going to even title this video because, okay. Okay, So this is the scripture the Lord gave me this morning. He therefore that ministereth to you the Spirit, the Holy Spirit, and worketh miracles among you, doeth he it by the works of the law or by the hearing of faith? See, we need to stop thinking that miracles are like, oh, OMG, that was such a miracle. You know, miracles happen every single day. We are all living in a world of miracles. God himself is a miracle. And the way he created us is a miracle. We living, still living, we are miracles. We are walking miracles. And, you know, we need to stop seeing miracles as things that are unattainable, and like are just so extraordinary and so supernatural. Well, they are supernatural. And so here it is. It's like bottom line. He that ministereth to you the Spirit and worketh miracles among you, doeth he it by the works of law or by the hearing of faith? You see, God wants to get all the glory. And if he is not the one that does something for you, then how's he going to get glory? He's not going to get glory. You or somebody else is going to get glory. So sometimes, you know, God, you know, pulls back and waits on us to see, are we really going to believe? Are we really going to believe? And so I believe, Lord, there's people out there that need miracles. And you told me this morning, Lord, to put this scripture up on my X account. And that this scripture and the Word of God is pure power. And it is wonder-working power. And so, Lord, people need miracles today, Lord. We need miracles every day, Lord. But we need to see. People need to see miracles, Lord, for them so that they can have faith and believe. Because after they saw the miracles, they believed. That's what your Bible says, the Gospels. After they saw the miracles, then they believed. And you know, overcome evil with good. Overcome evil with good. You said in your word, overcome. So it's really hard sometimes, you know, to overcome evil, because we aren't that good sometimes. And that's okay, because you saved us anyway, and we don't have to be perfect. You know, perfectionism and procrastination, all these things that are that war against us, I'll come against it right now in the name of Jesus. Procrastination and confusion is not of God. And then I was in the car a while ago listening to the word on the radio, and a minister was talking about the last days. And I really, you know, I'm going to come against again and again and again. There's things out there that are lies, pure lies. And, you know, if they're lies and you know they're lies, then we have authority over them. We as Christians, as a church. And we continue to come against the lies of the devil and jihad and religious persecution, attacks on Christians in Africa, Nigeria. We bind you in the name of Jesus, you spirit from hell, jihad of death and destruction. We bind you. And I'm not going to say everything I bind, but there's other things in the situation that I bind in the name of Jesus. Those are things for the closet, so to speak. And then Biden's speech last night, I wasn't going to watch it, and then I did, and then I gave a, you know, I made my comments on my ex account. I'm sorry, forgive me for going on and on and on, but couldn't help myself. 2 Corinthians 2. And I, brethren, when I came to you, came not with excellency of speech or of wisdom, declaring unto you the testimony of God, for I determined not to know anything among you save Jesus Christ and Him crucified. And I was with you in weakness and in fear and in much trembling, and my speech and my preaching was not with enticing words of man's wisdom, but in demonstration of the Spirit and of power, that your faith should not stand in the wisdom of men, but in the power of God. Howbeit we speak wisdom among them that are perfect, yet not the wisdom of the world, nor of the princes of this world that come to naught, but we speak the wisdom of God in a mystery, even the hidden wisdom which God ordained before the world unto our glory, which none of the princes of this world knew, for had they known it, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. But as it is written, eye hath not seen, nor ear heard, neither have entered in the heart of man the things which God hath prepared for them that love him. Now, I used to see this scripture as like a promise down the road. No, it's not for down the road, it's for right now. It's for right now, but as it is written, eye hath not seen nor ear heard, neither have entered into the heart of man the things which God hath prepared for them that love him. Right now, Lord, you prepared those things from the foundation of the world, of the earth. And so we receive them now, Lord. But God hath revealed them unto us by his Spirit, for the Spirit searcheth all things, yea, the deep things of God. This is 1 Corinthians 2. For what man knoweth the things of a man save the spirit of man which is in him? Even so the things of God knoweth no man but the Spirit of God. Now I want to skip down here. Now, not going to just skip one verse, I'm just going to keep reading. Which things also we speak not in the words which man's wisdom teacheth, but which the Holy Ghost teacheth, comparing spiritual things with spiritual. And here's the verse I want to really emphasize. But the natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit of God, for they are foolishness unto him, neither can he know them, because they are spiritually discerned. But he that is spiritual judgeth all things, yet he himself is judged of no man. For who hath known the mind of the Lord, that he may instruct him? But we have the mind of Christ. So when the Word of God and the spiritual things, those who have not received Christ, those who have not the Holy Spirit, those who have not received the Lord into their lives as their Lord, they've not been born again. So they don't understand these things. And that's why many times, even as Christians and conservatives, people out there in the world don't know what the heck we're talking about. And then those are people, there are also people that don't know what the heck we're talking about when we're talking about politics. And we think we know what we're talking about, and we do know many times, but sometimes we don't. We're not always right. We're not always correct. Even though they call us extreme right wing, and I'm not in that group, of course. Exactly. No, please drop that label. Because what you say with that label is making people out to be, and I know there's way people that are really out there that are really off. Okay. But many, for the most part, are just regular people. Hello, regular Americans, where are we? When we used to, you know, something would happen and we all get together and say, oh, praying for that person or praying, and we still do, but it's like, it's almost like, oh, we don't need your thoughts and prayers. Not this time. I'm just really rambling today. I'm really, really off and rambling. and maybe making no sense at all to some people, but so let's mix it up a little bit, okay? I'm tired, and I'm not tired, okay? You can't be tired. You cannot be tired, okay? You cannot be tired, okay? We don't want to be asleep, Lord. We don't want to be so spiritually asleep, okay? And also, Lord, we don't want to be so revved up that we are like, oh my goodness, Lord God Almighty. Sometimes I just watch things and I'm watching people and I'm watching this and that and I'm going, OMG. So anyway, Lord, hear our prayer. Hear our prayer, Lord, and you do. We cast the devil out right now. We take authority over you, Satan, in the name of Jesus Christ. You see, the church doesn't really teach these things. Some do, of course. But we need to, like, it's okay to let the world know there's a devil as well as a God, and that the devil is defeated, and that he does, but that he does go about as a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. And we bind you. We bind you, Satan. We bind you. You're not going to devour people with a slow suicide. Slow suicide. We bind it in the name of Jesus. No, 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 no. We bind it. We block it. Drugs, addiction, whatever it is, any kind of addiction that's trying to kill somebody, devil, we bind you behind the scenes in the name of Jesus. Hopelessness, we bind you in the name of Jesus. Father, we loose faith into people's lives. Faith. And faith moves mountains. And mountains don't have to be like these huge, big mountains all the time. No, little mountains have to move. Little mountains have to move. And give people a good day. Give people a great weekend. Give people a great month ahead. And Lord, thank you for answered prayer. Thank you for answered prayer, Lord. Thank you for the snow in California. The mountains need snow because we need the snow and the water supply. And if we need more, we need more, Lord. And help the authorities be wise with the water supply. We thank you for clean water all over America and around the world. Let's pray, church, for those areas that need prayer. Let's pray, church. We bind jihad in Jesus' name. We bind jihad against our brothers and sisters in Nigeria. Let's get out of our little box, church. If you go to church, if you don't go to church and you are a Christian, you are still a part of the church. And I know the Bible says, see, they'll always use these scriptures. If you departed from the faith, maybe you departed from the faith. And I'm seeing things, I'm going, OMG. Thank you, God, that I'm not the only one that sees things. Thank you, God, that I'm not the only one that sees things about people, some people. And I'm not going to name names right now because I'm a little tired. And I know this is just really like way, way, way out there today, but that's okay too. It needs to be okay, all right? It needs to be okay that we get on here and just share our hearts. Touch the children, Lord, and the parents. The starving and the hungry, and the Lord, the we come against mental illness in Jesus' name, and addiction, we come against it in the name of Jesus, and misdiagnosed by people that don't know what they're talking about. Lord, we just thank you for this day, and we give you all the praise and glory in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Have a great day. God bless. See you next time. Bye.